Good afternoon and welcome, especially to those of you watching online on YouTube. Hopefully you can see us and hopefully you can hear us as well. I'm just waiting for the sound to come through on my earpiece and then I'll know it's all working. I'm going to go and get Anita from outside shortly and our service will begin at 1 o'clock. Hopefully you won't lose us sound-wise or video-wise throughout the service. We have got a couple of bits of music that have got copyright on them, so YouTube may silence them partway through the service. There's nothing I can do about that. And if the internet goes, again, there's nothing I can do, but hopefully you'll be able to follow the whole service this afternoon as we celebrate with great joy the love between two wonderful people. So hang on tight, maybe go and make a cup of tea if you've not got one yet, and our service will begin shortly.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good afternoon and welcome to St. Michael and All Angels Parish Church. My name's Callum Piper, I'm the vicar here at St. Michael's, and it's a real joy to welcome all those of you here in the building and also to welcome those of you online. Thank you for waiting. The bride is here, as are all the bridesmaids, and so we gather to celebrate the love of Paul and Anita and to witness their marriage beginning and starting today, and praying for them that it may continue for the rest of their lives. There is a point during our service where I will ask you to join in, and that point will be once Anita and Paul have declared their intention to get married. Having declared their intention to get married, I will then ask you this question. Finding the right page. I will ask, will you, the families and friends of Anita and Paul, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come? The answer, nice and loudly, is we will. And you guys need to speak loudly so that this microphone picks you up, so that everyone on YouTube can hear. And those of you on YouTube, we may not be able to hear you, but we expect you to join in as well, because just as God is here, God is with you too. If you don't have an exemption, I do have to ask you to continue to wear your face mask throughout the service, and we will hear a number of pieces of music. Unfortunately, at the moment, we're not able to join in with those bits of music, so just allow the words to be sung over you by the recordings and to bless you. I think I've done enough speaking for now, so I'm going to ask you all please to stand for the entrance of the bride.
Right from the start, you were a thief, you stole my heart, and I, your willing victim, I let you see the parts of me that weren't all that pretty, and with every touch you fixed them. Now you've been talking in your sleep, oh, things you never say to me, oh, tell me that you've had enough of our love, our love. Just give me a reason, just a little bit's enough, just a second when I'm broken, just bend and we can learn to love again. It's in the stars, it's been written in the scars on our hearts. We're not broken, just bend and we can learn to love again.
I'm sorry, I don't understand where all of this is coming from. I thought that we were fine.
We had
everything. Your head is running wild again, my dear, we still have everything, and it's all in your mind.
Yeah, but this is happening.
You've been having real bad dreams. Oh, you used to lie so close to me. Oh, there's nothing more than empty sheets between
God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. We gather together to witness Paul and Anita's marriage to one another and to celebrate their love for one another. So let us pray. God of wonder and of joy, grace comes from you, and with you alone are the source of life and love. Without you, we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts and serve you always with willing minds, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I'm going to invite the congregation to be seated, and we're going to hear our first hymn. which is all things bright and beautiful. In the presence of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we have come together to witness the marriage of Paul and Anita, to pray for God's blessing on them, to share their joy, and to celebrate their love. Marriage is a gift of God in creation, through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that as man and woman grow together in love and trust, they shall be united with one another in heart, body, and mind, as Christ is united with his bride, the Church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children are nurtured and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship, and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ with those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty, which all should uphold and honor. It enriches society, it strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Anita and Paul are to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. We pray with them that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly life together. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. Great. Anita and Paul, the vows you are about to make are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Great. So, Paul, will you take Anita to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Anita, will you take Paul to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
And so those of you at home who hopefully can see and hear, those of you here present, will you, the family and friends of Anita and Paul, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come? Is that good enough? Yeah? Good. So as we've all made promises for going forwards, so we're going to pray. God, our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings upon Paul and Anita, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. So you two can go over there. And we're going to have our Bible reading, which Tom, I think, is going to bring us. And so I'm just going to raise the microphone up and turn it around so he can share.
Getting the perfect relationship. Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 to 17. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other, just as the Lord has forgiven you. So you almost must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your heart, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him.
Thank you. So I just want to take a few moments of our time together to reflect on that reading and to reflect on why we have gathered here today. In the reading that Paul and Anita have chosen, we're told that we are chosen ones, that we're holy, and that we're loved. And we're told that love isn't just a nice feeling that makes us all smile. Love isn't just something that brings us together for weddings. Indeed, love isn't something that all sorts of companies make millions out every year by Valentine's Day. Love has a quality and has a purpose that is active, that is alive, that is at work in us. And as we heard earlier on in our service, enriches society. And so in marriage preparation, when I normally get to do marriage preparation, because we don't do it over Zoom, I ask the couples a number of questions. And one of the questions that I almost always find fascinating is the question, what is the greatest gift your partner has ever given you? So I'm going to put you on the spot because I didn't get to ask you when we were preparing for today. Paul, what's the greatest gift Anita has ever given you? Love. That's a good answer, although it feels like a cop-out to me. And Lynn. Okay, and the kids. Anita, what's the greatest gift Paul has ever given you? Being himself. I always think the brides could say my engagement ring at this point, but they never do. We can see love in all sorts of ways. We can see love in the gifts that we give one another at special occasions, but we can also see love in the way we live our lives. We're told in the letter to Colossians that if we live with love, we live lives that are about kindness and compassion, lives with humility and patience. When I read this passage, certainly at weddings, I find myself ticking through this list going, oh, how I could do so much better. Having an 18-month-old, my patience has grown slightly, knowing that I need to become more patient with my son. But turn up at church on a Sunday and someone's moved the chairs ever so slightly, my patience disappears completely. So too, in the years ahead, you will have times where you grow short with each other, where you get frustrated at each other, where Paul has maybe not done the washing up like you asked him to do. But the quality of love that is on display today is about choosing to forgive, choosing to have patience, and choosing to care. The reason why I asked you what is the greatest gift you've ever given one another is because the definition of love elsewhere in Scripture is God. We're told that God is love, and those who live in love live in God. The love you two have for one another, the love each of us has for our partners and for Anita and Paul here today, originally comes from God. And the greatest gift he has ever given to display that love is his son, Jesus. The greatest gift, we're told in Scripture, that can ever be given is to lay one's life down for a friend. When you hear that passage, you might think of the armed forces. It's often read at armed forces events. But Jesus, in his love for us, his people, chose to die upon a cross on Good Friday and then to rise again. Not so that it was some historic thing that we would celebrate every year and enjoy Easter eggs, but that we might know true human love, which is on display today here at this wedding. And so in a few moments, as you get married, as we see you make promises to one another that will be for the rest of your life unbreakable, so there is a third part to your marriage which may be slightly more invisible. It's God. Because God loves you so much, he has shared himself with you. He has shared his love for you, and your love is the overflow of his love for you. So know that whoever you are, wherever you have come from, whatever your background, wherever you are going, know that you are loved by God, and that the love you experience from other humans and the love you offer to other humans is the overflow of God's love for you. You are loved beyond all your understanding. And today, as we witness your love for one another, we are reminded of how great God's love is for you. And in those days where your patience is wearing thin, in those days that you might describe as difficult days or hard days, know that love never ends. And just as love never ends, ask God for his help, for his patience, and for his peace to continue each day as you continue to love one another and be an example to all of us. Amen. I'm going to invite Anita and Paul to come and join me at the front again. And I think the best men and father of the bride is going to come and join us as well. I need to put the microphone down so everyone at home can hear you. And the first question I have to ask as we gather for this marriage part of the service is, who brings this woman to be married? You want to pass her hand into Paul's. Great. And so as they have joined hands, Paul, I ask you to repeat after me. I, Paul James.
I, Paul James.
Take you, Anita Joanne.
Take you, Anita Joanne.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
Have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
Presence of God, I made this vow.
Great, thank you. If you want to turn your hands over. Great. And Anita, please repeat after me. I, Anita Joanne.
I, Anita Joanne.
Take you, Paul James.
Take you, Paul James.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
Okay, you just want to loose hands for a moment. Best men, we practiced this last night, but without the rings. So hopefully you've got the rings, and if you have, if you could place them on there for me. Thank you very much. Thank you. You can go and sit down. Thank you. And so as we've got two rings here, both looking shiny and completely brand new, I'm going to pray over them that they might be a symbol for Paul and for Anita and for everyone that sees them, symbols of God's unending love and their unending love for one another. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Paul and Anita a symbol of unending love and faithfulness to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Do you want to take Anita's ring? Repeat after me. Anita, I give you this ring.
Anita, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Paul, I give you this ring.
Paul, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
If you want to. Addressed the dress.
More worried about my suit.
Hold hands. In the presence of God and before this congregation, Anita and Paul have given their consent and have made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. At this point, we can all cheer and go mad. Congratulations. So as a married couple, we're now going to pray for God's blessing upon them. So I'm going to invite them to kneel as we do so. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen. We're going to continue in prayer, and I invite you to join me when I say, Lord of life and love, to respond. Hear our prayer. Faithful God, holy and eternal, source of life and spring of love, we thank and praise you for bringing Paul and Anita to this day. And so we pray for them. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May their marriage be life-giving and lifelong. Enriched by your presence and strengthened by your grace, may they bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May the hospitality of their home bring refreshment and joy to all around them. And may their love overflow to neighbors in need and embrace those in distress. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May they nurture their family with devotion, see their children grow in body, mind, and spirit, and come at last to the end of their lives with hearts content and in joyful anticipation of heaven. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. As we join our prayers together with the words that Jesus taught us to pray in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. At this point in the service, traditionally, the bride and groom would go and sign the registers, but today is a historic day. Only 3 weeks ago, the government changed the law, and we no longer have registers to sign, so it won't take that long to do. We're still going to go and sign something, and then I will take it to the registry office on Monday, but it won't take as long, so we haven't got bits of music to play during, but if you could just hold tight for a few moments while we sign the legal document, and then we will continue with the final part of our service. But as we move to go and sign those that legal document, we're going to hear the words of Jerusalem. I'm going to invite the congregation, please, to stand. And so we have signed the legal document that the government think is the way forwards. And so they are now completely legally married. And so we're going to have a final prayer of blessing. And then I'm going to present the newly married couple to you. So let us pray. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love. Defend you on every side and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. And so it gives me great honor and privilege to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Lever.
Now you've been talking.